We're lounging. It's daytime. Oh, it's Sunday. Yeah, I love that save data. Did I buy shit already? What are we doing today? What is there to do today? He's there. Oh, it's Sunday. Duh. Did I buy this shit today? I must have. Whatever. What's happening here? Do you wear glasses?
Is that all you need?
Can't talk to her.
I've got some. Is that all you need? Hope to see you soon. Good day. Here are my requests.
I already brought her glasses. Who had it?
Wonderful. Of course.
I don't remember. Ooh, right.
Oh my. Then, let us be off.
Garnet. Sushi.
Very well.
Is there a sushi shop somewhere? Probably not over here.
Welcome.
Look at that fucking trash can. Ew.
Thank you.
I can't find sushi. Where am I gonna find this sushi? Whoa. Oh, there's a bunch of shit here. Holy. Get sushi in the... Nope. What? It's full.
Of course it's full.
Sushi in the pharmacy? No sushi? It's cat food.
Everything you need?
Salty fresh.
Done already? Come again, yeah?
In the cafe?
Good day. Here are my requests. Wonderful. Is that true?
Scrub brush? Oh no. Ragda, magician, Titania.
Do you see anything achievable?
Sush.
Very well.
Starting to settle down, I think. Thank you for coming. It's comforting to have someone with me. Why do I have to face this alone? Why am I the one? I can't run around like I did as a child anymore, because my legs and heart won't even let me. All that's left is to draw my sheets around me and count the beats of my heart until they stop forever. Why is this only happening to me? Of course not. No one could. I don't even know. I mean, I understand the reason I'm dying, but what even is the meaning of it? There isn't any meaning to life that I can find. So perhaps I'm not missing all that much. I wish I could run away, but if my body were capable of that, I wouldn't be here anyway. No matter what I do, my body is there to remind me I'm going to die. Why? Why me? Please don't leave just yet. It's almost too much for me if I'm alone. Right. I suppose I shouldn't. I can accept it. I'm feeling a little better now. Thank you. It's starting to get dark. Don't worry, I'll be fine now. I hope I can see you again soon.
Welcome back. Detected a gaze upon us for an estimated 7 minutes now.
Oh, sorry. I just wanted to watch. Was I bothering you? Huh? Are you trying to get back at me? I'm sorry. Is it all right if I study with you? If it isn't too much trouble, I mean.
My data states that elementary school does not feature regular examinations. Is this information inaccurate?
No, you're right. We don't really have tests that we need to study a whole week in advance for. Sorry, if you're not okay with it, I can just... Oh, thank you! I'll go get my workbooks now!
Next question. What is the term used to describe the property of having zero electrical resistance?
Oh, I know! Superconductivity!
Correct, Amada-san.
Yeah, that's it! The Featherman technique! It's so cool! I mean, that's what I heard from a friend, anyway. Oh, sorry, Koromaru. I guess I was being a little loud. Let's get back to studying.
It appears that Amada-san has entered a state of non-REM sleep. He is in a deep slumber. Sleeping here may cause his body temperature to decline sharply, risking illness. Shall we wake him? Understood. I wonder what kind of dreams Amada-san will have. Let's transport him carefully to prevent waking. I will accompany you on the way to his room.
met my quota! I found someone else to welcome into our vlog!
No! Speak of the devil!
Oh, wow! Are you interested in joining too? Finally, paradise is smiling back at me! Yes!
What are you saying? That I should just abandon these people to their fate? I'm trying to save these people. They've suffered in this world just like me. Someone as good-looking as you could never understand. You have no idea what people like me have to go through. Fine. If you're gonna try and stop me, then you and I are through!
Are they forcing us? Is that what this is?
Don't follow me around anymore! Only true believers are allowed into paradise! Emergency? A serious emergency?
So the world's coming to an end, huh? I think I remember some other cult saying stuff like that. Except they really weren't about initiation fees. It was more about giving up material wealth, wasn't it? Stealing ideas from real, actual religions. That's a textbook cult tactic, you know?
You mean this was all a trick?
Oh, yeah. You've been duped, kid. But not by us. You should blame that cult you believe in so much. Now that I know the truth, I almost feel sorry for you. But you had to take things too far. Try not to hit his face. If you leave any marks, you might be able to press charges.
But if I die here, I'll be reborn, and I can go to paradise. I'm not scared! I'm not scared! What? What are you doing here? After I said such awful things to you, that we were through! I'm freaking out! I don't want them to hurt me!
Never mind, we're good.
See you near my son again.
You're so wonderful. You have such a kind soul.
Oh, it's you.
Is I decided to hold this study session for us to concentrate on the upcoming exams. Amada, I invited you to join us so you can focus on your own studies. Your presence is welcome here.
Thank you for inviting me. I'll make sure not to be a bother to everyone.
To the rest of you, I want you to set a proper example and take your studies seriously.
Are you going to study with us, Koro-chan? Good boy!
Koromaru-san says that he will accompany us here as we study.
Well, aren't you a little hard worker?
Unlike Junpei over there, who can't stop yawning.
I can't really deny it. Wouldn't mind being in his place right about now. Dogs never have to study for exams like this. Man, what a life.
Stay!
Go home?
Time for me to go back to my room! Wait, they'll try to get rid of me!
Koromaru-san may not have an obligation to study, but he has another important mission.
True. He's been protecting that shrine this whole time. That sounds like something far more difficult.
Guess if you want to be a dog, you'd better develop some diligence, like Koromaru here.
Being a dog is harder than it seems. You'd be better off just studying, Junpei-san.
Oh, stop! Don't look at me like some pitiful creature!
All right, that's enough chit-chat. Let's concentrate on our studies.
That was 3 points of intelligence and nothing?
All right, I think we can begin wrapping things up. Good work, everyone. And Iori, after all the dog talk, I do hope you were able to get through the material you needed to cover.
What?
Oh, I see. So you're still learning then. As a dog, I'll need to give you strict behavioral training.
I'm kidding! It was a joke! I'm totally cool being human. No training needed! I'm good!
That will conclude the group study session. It is time for a much-deserved rest.
Is it time to pull up the cheat sheet? Name a system for its overproduction of dopamine? Is that addiction? October midterm? It's addiction. Indeed, addiction. Mathematical theorem. Pythagoras. Electrical resistance reaches zero. Superconductivity cyclone! To spill the beans to reveal a secret. think I could have gotten all those without the cheat sheet. Those are all things I would have known. Questions are just too easy. This one in particular was just too easy. If I may say so myself. I already read that one. NG. Gonna rush Fuka.
In a bookstore once. I think it was at the start of last April. Someone took a picture of me. They accused me of stealing. I'm not very tall, right? So when I was reaching for a high shelf, I accidentally knocked some books down. Well, a few of them landed in my bag. I went to take them out and put them back on the shelf. But some girl from my class took a picture of me with her cell phone. She even threatened to show my parents. Right? I bet you think I'm stupid for letting this get to me. If I'd just spoken up, I could have settled it right there. I know that. But I still couldn't say anything back. All these negative thoughts kept running through my head. I thought no matter what I said, it wouldn't do any good in the end. But now, I want to believe that I can change. Whenever I'm with you, I feel like I don't get swept up in those negative thoughts. I know I'm being selfish, but... I'm sorry. I don't know what I'm saying. I'm making it sound like I'm just using you, aren't I? That's not what I meant, really. What I'm trying to say is... I've really come to depend on you, and... I'm really happy that you're there for me. That's all. Oh, sorry. I'm always going on about my own problems. At this rate, I'm never going to be able to repay you. I should have just discussed my cooking concerns with everyone at the dorm, but... somehow, I find myself always going to you for help. I want to hear your opinion, but more than that, I feel at ease when you're with me. I wonder why. I'm sure it's because you're a leader. That's why I depend on you so much. Well, maybe that isn't the only reason. Sorry, I think I need to go back to the dorm. I need some time to get my thoughts in order. Could we talk about this again later? Thank you. I'm going to head back now.
Uncle Rochon.
I'm used to being accosted by people, but recently I had an interesting encounter. It was a young man, not much older than you. Do you know what he said to me? He said, "Thank you." I'm not proud of this or anything, but I couldn't care less what our customers think. Don't you know who I am? I'm the president of a company that sells fake products. But then, he told me he quit his part-time job and was going to study to become a public prosecutor. He wants to punish businessmen like me for bending the rules. He said I was an example of a negative role model, even though I wasn't aware of it. Maybe I'm overreacting, but what if he does become a public prosecutor and puts me behind bars? I suppose that means I wouldn't be able to give you my advice anymore. Shareholders ought to take a leaf out of that boy's book. Apparently, these days aren't as naive as we thought.
Words on the tiny screen. Instant curry. Kare 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 kare. boy. I don't want to hang out with that dude. Come on. It's a new moon.
Doing better today. I know it probably looked dire last time, right? Sorry if I scared you. I'd been reading a book before we met that day. I guess I got so absorbed in it that I didn't realize how cold the wind was. Do you enjoy reading books?
He said the wind.
I see. That's something we have in common then. Nowadays, reading books is all I do. I find that they give me a way to escape everything else. I can just get lost in the book's private world. Do you read books all the way through? Oh, you do? I don't like to see them end. The more engaging a story is, the more I want to get lost in it. But I'm always afraid to finish it. Because once I finish the story, I'll have to come back to reality. This inescapable body of mine. Heartwarming stories filled with hope. Those are the kinds of books I like to read. They give me a little solace when I have to come back to the real world. Looks like the sun is already setting. Time is so ruthless. I hope we have another chance to talk.
Yes, of course.
Oh, it's you.
Hoping you could watch me as I make the coffee. Thank you. Okay, the beans are freshly ground and accurately measured. The water is about 90 degrees Celsius. Now, the pace and angle when pouring the water are really important. All right, here I go. Pour slowly and quietly in a circular motion. You'll know you're doing it right when it starts smelling really good. It's not exactly what you'd get at a cafe, but I think I've improved a lot. There's so much to consider when making coffee. I get why people are so particular about it. I know it's a bit weird to ask at this point, but when do you feel like drinking coffee the most? Oh, Are you more of a tea person, like Mitsuru-san? In all honesty, I never really went out of my way to drink it either. When my mom was still alive, the house used to smell like this every morning. Now I realize how often she'd make coffee, even on days she was busy. I saw on TV the other day that smells and memories are linked closely together. The smell of coffee reminded me of my mom. But in your case, I wonder if it'll remind you of the times we spent here, drinking coffee together. In that case, I'd better practice and treat you to another cup while we still have time. It'd be pretty sad if you only remembered my coffee being bitter. I feel like I haven't gotten into something like this for a long time. I also think it's helped me practice staying focused. Maybe it's because I've been doing it so diligently.
Ooh, that's pretty good.
Anyways, thanks a lot. Because of you, I think I understand the taste of coffee a little better now. Besides, if my mom liked it, I'm sure I will too. Oh, there's still more if you want a refill. I've gotten a lot better now. So I hope you'll join me again sometime. Next time, it's gonna be even better than it was today.
It becomes this.
Hey, so, never mind. Just forget about it.
Forget about it.
I guess saying that only makes you more curious, huh? Yeah, I'm not surprised. Sorry about that. So, you might have forgotten all about this, and it's totally fine if you did.
But when we were at Yakushima, I said some stupid things. And I just wanted to say I'm sorry. It's been on my mind this whole time. You know, I always felt like I wanted to just be normal. I wanted to have a family like all the other kids. Mom and Dad to come home to. Why do we have to be different? Why us? Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to lump the two of us together. But I feel like you understand and have been looking out for me. At least that's what I think. Is that just wishful thinking? That's how I really feel, though.
I am thou. Thou art I. Thou hast established a new bond. Thou shalt have our blessing when thou choosest to create a persona of the Lovers Arcana.
It's getting cold. Let's go home.
Woof.
Excuse me.
Chill vibes. Good night, Tom.
She's like the most animated, so I was wondering if she would freeze in whatever animation she was in. And I guess she does. Interesting. I need to watch a movie with you? No. Not now, boy. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Tsuru is there. Let's go, Sadie. Hello, Tsuru.
Oh. Excellent.
So dance. If you wanna go ahead, free to do whatever. I'm chilling on my bed. I'm out in my biz, so mind your own biz. Whatever like is. Hey, feeling the fire with the burning desire every day. Where's my
You got food?
Yo.
I owe you one.
Sorry I'm late. I ran into some unexpected trouble. All right, here goes. Back me up, would you? I'm gonna make pancakes.
Pancakes?
Think you can help? I guess you could say I've got a craving. I used to eat them all the time at the orphanage. I know they sell frozen ones nowadays, but nothing beats freshly cooked, right? I don't really need a reason, do I? I just felt like it. Well, let's go on and get started. Okay, first things first. What exactly do we do first? I think the recipe said to use lots of butter and to regulate the pan's temperature with a damp washcloth. Wait, we put a washcloth in the pan?
That doesn't sound right.
Won't it burn? You sure? Thanks. I don't know how to cook anything besides the stuff I use for bodybuilding. I can break the eggs and mix the batter. I'll leave the actual cooking part to you. Oh, so that's how you use the washcloth. How about we add some protein powder? Hey, don't look at me like that.
Protein powder.
I better go get the plates. All right, I think this will be enough.
Oh, check it out! Wow, look at all the pancakes! I knew something smelled good!
Yeah, just give me a minute. We can eat once I bring them out. Would you mind getting everyone else? And don't forget Amada.
Okay!
Oh, it's like a Tartarus of pancakes!
Did the two of you make all of these yourselves?
Yeah, although this guy was the one who cooked them. I said I had a hankering, but we might have made too much. I like pancakes, but no way I can eat all of these myself. If you guys could pitch in, that'd be great.
So you like pancakes too, Sonata-san?
Thank you. I can't wait to have some.
I'll make some tea. I've got some leaves that'd be great for the occasion.
It's pancake party time.
Pancake party time? Who says that? Who taught you that lingo, I guess?
Thanks for the pancakes. They were really good. Tasted like a lot of care went into them. If you ever make some again, I'd like to help out too.
For as many as we made, they sure did disappear fast. Cooking's not really one of my strong points. A certain someone would always say, if you pour protein powder on the ingredients, then you shouldn't be in the kitchen, dumbass. Most of the time, I only ever got to watch someone else cook. So I never really learned myself. Anyways, thanks for helping out today. I'm hoping that cheered everyone up a little. Yeah, pretty much. They did things like this back when I was at the orphanage. I just wanted to recreate it. My sister used to cry all the time there. But the pancakes always brought a smile to her face. Do you remember that medal you found in the package from my parents? My sister, Miki. She made that back when we were at the orphanage. Based on the letter that came with it, I guess my parents found it when they were cleaning. Miki was gonna give that to me after we learned I was getting adopted out and leaving. But then that fire happened right after. And this medal was all that was left of her. Apparently, Miki used to always say she wanted to thank me for being so strong and kind. She was really quiet. And she'd always be following me around. I don't really remember doing anything special for her. But I guess she was relying on me as her older brother. Seeing that medal made me think, would my sister be proud of who I am now? Am I really strong and kind enough to deserve that medal? If I'm being honest, I don't really know what it means to be strong or kind. Everyone who's ever said that to me has left without telling me the most important part. You saw how I was today. This is all I'm capable of right now. I haven't grown at all since I was a kid. They'd laugh if they saw me now. That's true. Sweet foods can relieve fatigue. I think I'll be ready to fight again by tomorrow. I realized I'd just been running away all this time, making excuses about having my own problems. But from now on, I'm gonna protect it all. We promised we'd become strong together. I won't let him down. Thanks, I really appreciate that. I'll be counting on you next time. The point of this whole thing was to cheer everyone up. And yet I'm the one getting supported here, you know? I think you're the kind of person my sister would have looked up to. All right, that's enough talking about the past. Let's hurry up and finish clean. Well, I ran into that group of punks on my way home from shopping today. There were even more of them this time. And one guy managed to get a good hit in. Don't worry, though. I didn't do anything that would get me in trouble with the police. I just let them throw as many punches as they wanted until they got tired and gave up. I thought I could dodge them all, but I guess I've still got room to improve.
Wrong stat, wrong stat, wrong stat. Tuesday.
All right, time for class. I know you've been busy lately, but you all remembered to do your homework, right? Just because you're not taking a humanities class next year doesn't mean you can blow off classic lit. Hey, are you all listening to me?
What's wrong, Fuka? You look kind of down. Huh? Talk to me. What's bothering you?
It's just... Aragaki-senpai.
Oh. Yeah, it's pretty shocking. I'd never seen him in school, but he'd always be hanging around town. And now he's just... gone. It's hard to put it into words.
I took it for granted that everyone would always be around, that nothing would ever change. Some things you can never get back. I didn't consider how easily it could happen. Once I realized that, I started thinking about my parents. I've sort of been avoiding the question, but... is it okay for me to leave things with them like this?
Parents, huh? Yeah, that's a tough one. But I think you'll work it out, Fuka.
Moriyama, what are you waiting for? Come on up. Would it kill you to give your classmates a proper goodbye?
Huh? What's going on?
Hi everyone. I know I haven't been here that long, but I feel like I've made some good friends. I'll remember each and every one of you after I transfer. Thank you all. How's that?
Wait, transfer?
What?
You're a weird one, you know that? The biggest bitch in school is leaving and you're gonna miss her?
You're transferring... and you didn't say anything?
It's not like it would have made a difference. Why make us both depressed? But yeah, my dad suddenly collapsed. And they say it'll take a while for him to recover because of some complications. We don't really have that much money, so we can't afford to stay in this area. You know, now that I think about it, you're the only one who bothered being friends with a weirdo like me. But like I said before, we're both in the same boat. My parents act like I don't even exist, I hate living with them. That's why I was so jealous when you moved into the dorm.
Natsuki-chan.
You know, you've really changed, Fuka. You're a lot more cheerful now. But why'd you move when your house is, like, right here?
Huh? Well,
if you don't want to say, that's okay. I'm sure you've got your reasons. But if it's something that you and your parents can work out, then do it while you have a chance. It'll be a while before my dad's in any condition for us to have a heart-to-heart. What am I doing? This isn't what I wanted to talk about. You know, Fuka, I used to think every day was just the same depressing routine. And I'm only saying this because it's you, but you don't really get many second chances in life.
Natsuki-chan.
I guess this is the last time I'll see this view. I won't be in school next week because I'll be packing, so I guess this is goodbye.
No!
Don't you dare come see me off. I want to say goodbye on my own terms. Come on, don't give me that look.
But you're leaving so suddenly.
Hey, I'm not all broken up about this, just so you know. I've changed a lot since I met you. I'm gonna try and figure out what I really want to do with my life.
I know you can do it, Natsuki-chan.
Well, now I really feel like I gotta do it. No pressure, right?
No.
I got one last thing I want to say before I go. If you just accept the way things are, then you'll never move forward. Just like me. So I hope you can figure out what you want, too.
What I want? I used to try and please everyone, just to fit in. I was afraid of not being liked, so I always went along with the people around me. But I never really thought about what I wanted.
That's so you. Well, if they don't like you for who you are, I say screw them. But I like you, Fuka. Even if you hate yourself.
Natsuki-chan.
Well, I better get going.
Natsuki-chan? Here, even if we're apart, we're still connected. So, we can always talk, right? Thanks for being my friend. I'm kinda tearing up now. Natsuki-chan. Even if we're apart, we're still connected. I get it now, Natsuki-chan. I'd always assumed my powers were a reflection of my faults. I was always worried about how other people see me, and that's why my powers let me see others. There is something I want after all. Seeing everyone getting along and working together makes me so happy. So, I want us to treasure this forever. I have the power to connect people, even when they're apart. My persona has given me this amazing gift. The friendship I've always wanted.
Juno.
There you are.
Oh, what are you all doing here? It is unusual to find you up on the rooftop.
Well, we didn't see you around, so we weren't sure if you were all right.
I think I figured it out.
Okay?
I've made up my mind. I'm going to do everything I can with the power I've been given. This is what I've decided I want to do.
Sure?
Sorry. I guess that was out of nowhere, wasn't it?
You sure you're all right?
This is questionable. Affirmative.
Yes.
My lunch today. I think I may have caught a cold. I'm sorry, but do you think we could go to the pharmacy? I'm going to go get some medicine. I'll be right back.
Oh, hey there! You on your way home from school?
Huh? Well, what do you want?
Wow, you're really cute. From this angle, I can see how gorgeous you are in those glasses. Say, you want to maybe sit down in a cafe and chat a little?
I...
Hey, come on, don't be scared. I'm not gonna bite.
No, please stop. Senpai.
Huh? Who the hell are you? Wait, don't tell me that you're with her. No, I thought I had a chance since you look so plain.
Oh, thank goodness. I thought you were going to hit him for a second. I wouldn't want you to get into a fight because of me. But just now, you are so... You've already saved me, so I'm not scared anymore. But why am I still shaking? Did help calm me down a bit. Thank you. I think I'm fine now. Huh? Why do I suddenly feel short of breath? Senpai, I think I really did catch a cold. I feel like my face is all flush. Thank you again for saving me today. Now, please excuse me.
By the way,
very puzzling. The plants seem much livelier than they did when we started. Do you suppose they're happy that you are tending to them? Fascinating. There's no data on this, but it seems like you understand them. Hello, plants. I will be tending to you as well this time. Don't worry, I'll make sure to decrease my pressure output. But if anything starts hurting, just raise your left hand, or rather, your left leaf. I had some prior knowledge of plants, but this was my first time observing them directly. These little seeds and buds in the earth can morph and change so quickly. Is this proof that they are living as well? How fascinating. I would like to watch these plants grow and document this experience for my records. I will tend to them with my full power. This took more time than I'd anticipated. I will need to run more simulations to ensure there are no delays next time. It's gotten late. We should head back now.
Good morning. This is Elizabeth. I am calling to inform two this time, I believe. And there seems to be an... I suggest... Goodbye now.
An acquaintance of mine? Who? Michael. Oh no. Goral. Why did you wander into Tartarus?
What kind of persona do you desire?
Please take a look. Browse to your heart's content. Take a look.
Are you finished? Are you...
Which will you... Well, then. Shall we take a look?
You'll be summoning this one. May it be your inner strength.
Ah, well then. Shall we take a look?
Are you satisfied with this? Please choose what skills to inherit. Choose what skills to inherit.
It appears it will receive a large... Well, well, well.
This persona is powerful. Very well. We look... Welcome to the Velvet Room. This is your progress so far. So you'll be summoning this one? May it be your inner strength. Very well. We look...
Auntie Yuko is fine.
One, two, three. Good luck with your boyfriend!
They called you my boyfriend till the very end. Yeah, I know that. Those kids even call Kaz my boyfriend when I'm with him. You know what this feels like? The end of some cheesy high school drama series. Like the kids have left the nest. Now that it's suddenly so quiet. Yeah, a little. Although it was pretty tough at the beginning. Teaching those kids how to race. It was pretty fun. They looked so happy every time they got faster. And it made me happy too. That feeling of wanting to help them just kept growing bigger and bigger. You know, this might have been the first time I really put my heart into something. And it's not that I've been slacking off as a team manager, but maybe helping and teaching people is more of my thing. Kind of made me think about the things I should do for my future, I mean. Oh, by the way, I wanted to thank you. Maybe we should throw a little party, you know, to celebrate our first attempt at coaching. Yay! Oh, I can't wait.
Why?
Now where should we have the party at? I kind of want it to be somewhat fancy. I'll look around for a place. I didn't have much confidence at the beginning, so you being here with me was really... Well, let's talk about that next time. We'll have plenty of time at the party. Shall we head home?
Welcome back!
All right. Reminds me, I was reading this book during class once. One of our classmates saw and said to me, "Wow, I'm surprised. So you're the type to talk with your fists. What exactly do I look like to everyone else?" I see. That must mean that I don't appear to be strong in other people's eyes. I am an anti-shadow weapon, but I don't seem to be regarded as such. I must correct this problem at once. If it is not addressed, it could negatively impact my ability to carry out my duties. Once I finish reading, I will start thinking of a solution. During combat, the mental states of both sides play a significant role in the outcome. I want my presence to strike fear in the hearts of my enemies, but galvanize my allies as well. What can I do to convey that kind of impression? Ideally, it would be something to encourage people to depend on me. Maybe I can find some tips in this book.
Wrong stat.
This is enough reading for now. We should return to our rooms.
Attention, please.
Wrong stat.
Doesn't Miyamoto seem slower lately?
Yeah, he's not keeping his usual pace.
He thinks he'll make it to the Nationals like that?
You guys have nothing better to do? Why don't you give me a hand with the laundry? The only thing they're good at is kicking up dirt. Hey, Kaz! Coach wants to see you in the office.
Okay, be right there.
Hey. Never mind. I think we can wrap up practice for today.
Hey! Let's walk home together.
So, the coach told me my performance has been slipping. I know you didn't say anything. I just think he can tell something's up. It's sore, sure, but I managed to make it through practice today. He said I'd be suspended from the team if I'm hurt, but I told him I was fine. I've already missed practice 3 times this year. I'm gonna have to seriously step up my game. Otherwise, I won't be able to keep my promise to my nephew. You're right. In the end, it's the toughest one who wins. I've decided that I'll take my chances for my nephew's sake. Even if I mess up my knee for the rest of my life, if that happens, I want you to be the next captain.
No thanks. I'll pass.
It's not exactly the happiest topic. That's just the worst case scenario. I'm gonna keep my promise, win the meet, then the Nationals. Then I'll take care of my knee. Nothing can stop me now.
Oh, it's you.
Leader, I have a suggestion.
Hello. Yo.
So dance, if you wanna go ahead, free to do whatever, I'm chilling on my bed. I'm out in my biz,
hey.
So mind your own biz, whatever like is, we gon' flow with the set.
By the way.
Hey, hey, feeling the fire with the burning desire, every day we inspire, but never expires, but we gon' chill today.
Thank you.
Welcome to the Velvet Room. This is your progress so far. You can't carry any more than that.
I too. Which of you? All the elements you need?
Is this acceptable? This persona, yes? What do you wish to inherit?
It appears it will receive a large amount of... Why, this is exciting, isn't it?
You can't control this one. This persona is powerful. Please, take a look. So you'll be summoning this. May it be your inner strength. Very well. We look.
So... glad to hear it.
Thank you.
day. Are you accepting a wonderful? Is that true? You have my thanks. Very well.
What is it? And what's with the scary look?
What do you think you're doing?
Just practicing?
Well, that's enough practice for you. Get your butt to the nurse's office. The rest of you, get back to it.
The nurse's office? Miyamoto, did something happen?
Liar. You can totally tell he's going easy on one knee. I know you have something to do with this. Sorry, but you're coming too.
I just had a call with your mom about your knee.
You're throwing caution to the wind, young man.
That blabbermouth.
I want you to stop before things get any worse. You got that?
Don't do this to me. I need to practice.
I heard, Kaz.
Yuko? And you too?
Take some time off, Kaz. Practice can wait till you're all better.
I can't! I don't have time!
Huh? What's the rush? Why do you do these things to yourself?
You've been hanging around with Miyamoto lately, right? You must know what's going on.
Stop. Stop. I don't want you to lie for me. I don't want you to get dragged into this. So I'll come clean. So, the truth is, and that's the gist of it. So I need to practice. I have to win, or else.
I know how you feel, Miyamoto, but
it all depends on me if my nephew ever walks again.
So that's what's going on.
I don't mind if he competes in the regionals. It's just the individual competition, so we don't have to worry about him bringing us down.
Hey, what happened to practice?
We were worried about Miyamoto.
Guys.
I'll let you keep training for now. We'll see how things go. But if I tell you to stop, I'm sorry. You're gonna have to listen, and I want you to go home today. Your mother will be upset with me if I let you stay.
Sorry, Coach. Everyone,
I think we're done here. The rest of you, back to training.
Control until the very end. That last line he exchanged with the casino's boss gave me goosebumps. And how about that part when he was all, count to five? I hope I can be like him when I'm an adult. What do you think it takes for a guy to be hard-boiled? That's true. The detective did always make the right call, no matter what situation he was in. He was compassionate, but level-headed, and he never fell for the enemy's tricks. Come to think of it, that might be just what I need right now. I tend to get worked up about what's right in front of me, don't I? That's exactly the kind of thing a kid would do. I need to fix that. Well, now's as good a time as any to start. I'll give it my best shot. If I do that, do you think I could become like him? A cool, hard-boiled guy. Just like the detective in the movie. When I hear you say it, I really feel like it's possible.
Even better. 10 SP?
Oh boy, look at the time. But I still want to talk about the movie. Wait, I'm not sleepy yet, okay?
Rocks that.
Once you should kill.
Prepare to be.
Prepare to be.
Sorry. No one was here, so I figured it'd be okay.
It's rare to see you here. Is it for the archery team?
Yes, the teacher wanted a report.
I see. That's a lot of responsibility.
Oh, not really. It's nothing compared to what you have to do. Actually, I wanted to ask you something.
Hmm?
Senpai, what are you fighting for?
Well, I guess you could say it's my way of atoning for the past.
In my case, I don't think I really have a reason anymore. I mean, I know the whole story about my father now. I guess I could still fix the mistakes he left behind, though. Maybe I should have thought about this earlier, huh? But it took me this long to start questioning myself.
That's understandable.
It seems like everyone has their own reason for fighting. Well, defeating the shadows is probably a good enough reason, huh?
What are you trying to say?
I'm not exactly sure, but it's all gonna be over after the next full moon, so there's not much point in thinking about it.
That's true. Once we put an end to this, we can go back to a normal high school life. The rest of the student council will be here soon. We can pick this up later, though, if you want.
Oh no, that's okay. Thanks for listening.
They didn't evolve their personas yet? Chihiro doesn't want to hang out. Or things in advance.
Good grief.
soon.
Whoa.
Sorry that the party ended up being at my place. I was out buying stuff that might be useful for running practice, and I ran out of money. Oh, really? Good thing I took the time to tidy up. Feel free to eat as many snacks as you want, okay? It was a lot of hard work, but I'm glad we decided to coach those kids in the end. What do you think? Sorry. It's just, I never noticed how long your eyelashes are. I don't think I've looked at you this closely before. It's only the two of us here now. Maybe that's why I'm a little nervous. How about we change the subject? I'll ask you a question. Oh, do you like children? Really? Me too. I like how they're so pure and always try their best. It just makes me want to support them as much as I can. I realized recently how much I like to look after other people. Let's see. Okay, next question. Let's say you get married and have a kid. Would you want it to be a boy or a girl? Is that really how guys think? Oh, if you mean you don't care as long as the baby is healthy, then I agree with you. Either way, I would just hope that the baby didn't take after me. Say I'm a little rough around the edges. But if they took after you, I'm sure they'd be super cute. They'd probably be athletic too. I wonder if they'll take an interest in sports. By the way, do you look more like your dad or your mom? I've been told that I'm the spitting image of my dad. It's not that I mind, but you have mixed feelings about it. I mean, we don't look that much alike, right? My eyebrows aren't as bushy for one.
Hmm.
I see you're back.
Bakihiko? Hmm. Depends on who you run into.
Oh, what a coincidence. Hey, I didn't know you had a dog. Is that a Shiba? That white fur is really nice. Almost makes him look mystical or something, don't you think?
This could be fun.
Oh man, he just looks so cool. I wonder how soft he is.
Hey, yo.
Well, I don't want to make him uncomfortable or anything. Hey, do you think I could try petting him next time? I'll study up the proper way to do it.
But it's Sunday.
No.
It's amazing.
Pumpkin mask.
I got really into my reading last night, and never went to sleep. I thought I'd be fine, since I've lost sleep from the pain and anxiety of my illness before, but I suppose I'm not doing my health any favors like this. Thank you. Or rather, I suppose I should apologize. It's been so long since anyone told me off or anything. I came out here because I was hoping to find you. I only have so much time left, you know. Do you remember when I said I like reading heartwarming stories? There are as many stories as there are stars in the sky, but I don't think any of them are what I'm looking for. The problem is, none of those stories were written for people like me. I guess I'm just being selfish. Just like I am with you, too. You're always coming to visit me, keeping me company and talking with me. How much of your valuable time have you spent with me? I don't deserve it. You're spoiling me. That's why I like you so much, though. Sorry, I was in such a good mood that I overexerted myself. I'd like to see you again sometime.
Appears to be less damage from pests than the data in my prediction suggests. We haven't taken any specific measures against them. What is the cause of this? Oh, this is... Look, I've sighted a ladybug larva. It's very small and adorable. Agreed. We wouldn't want to interrupt it while it's eating. Ladybugs are the natural predators of pests that damage plants. That would explain why there weren't any harmful insects around. Thank you very much, little ladybug. Even in just these tiny planters, there is so much life.
There's no one to teach them. They're just doing the best they can. Hmm. My apologies. I got distracted. Let's keep working. Excuse me. Please apply the repellent on that end. Pests deserve no mercy. Status reads all green. No problems to report. That concludes our mission for today. We should head back now. Status reads all green. No problems to report.
That is incorrect.
Listen.
I've been waiting for you. Oh my. Marvelous. I'm looking forward to it. How may I assist you? Now then.
Please choose the persona. Well then, shall we take a look?
This would be a wise choice. Very well. We look. Good. Here are my requests. Very well. Welcome to the Velvet Room.
What kind of persona?
This persona is powerful. This persona is powerful. Please choose what skills to inherit.
It seems you have been blessed.
So it begins. This would would be a wise choice. Are you finished? We look for... Good day. Are you accepting a request? Wonderful. House. By all means. Very well. Are too fragrant. Roses aren't really my thing. Maybe Gerberus? Oh, sorry. I'm redecorating my room and was thinking of getting some flowers to go with it. I think I'll go with the Gerberus. What color do you think I should get? You think so? I like pink too. I guess we have the same taste, huh? Then it's decided. I'll get these. Come to think of it, Gerberas by themselves might be a little plain. What other flowers do you think would look nice? Oh, wait, you've never seen my room, have you? Well then why am I even asking you? The truth. To be honest, any flowers would be fine if they were from you. Just kidding. Wow, look at the time. Gosh, what should I get? I'm actually a pretty indecisive person. Ranunculus wouldn't be bad either.
Welcome back. I have a suggestion.
You know what? Yep.
Hmm.
Welcome to the Velvet Room.
What kind of persona do you desire?
Please take a look. So you'll be summoning this one? Very well, it's yours.
Do you have some time to chat after art club? Everyone's working so hard. Is that what it seems like to you? That I'm working hard? Well, I told my dad about studying abroad. He said I should give it a try. And just the other day, he was telling me to quit. He's always wanted me to be a doctor till now. So for him to say that, I just don't know what to think. Yeah, that's true. But at the same time, if I study abroad, it kind of feels like I'm doing it because that's what my dad wants. Thanks. This has been eating me up for a while, and it feels good to talk about it. You're really the only one I can talk to about this stuff. It's great that you've always made your own decisions. Not like me, though. Sorry, we should get going. My driver's picking me up, so I can have him drop you off near your dorm if you want.
Your driver? Homie's got a driver?
Welcome to the Velvet Room.
Ah, well then. Shall we take a look? Take all the time you need to consider.
Acceptable? This persona, yes? What do you wish to inherit? would wish to inherit.
It appears it will receive a...
Well then, shall we begin?
This power might be too much for you. This persona is powerful. Is this acceptable? Very well.
Day, a woman came to my office asking for a donation. Quite the looker, I might add. In fact, she was very much my type. But no matter how attractive she was, I was repulsed by her dedication to charity work. If I say no, the tabloids are gonna tear me to shreds. Why should I have to give my hard-earned money to a bunch of freeloaders? I pulled myself up out of squalor to get where I am today. I wanted to get back at the ones who used to laugh at me. That's what I always dreamed of, anyway. But, to tell you the truth, now I have too much money. Profits are booming. I'm so busy, I don't have time to spend a yen of it. Maybe I should train someone to take my place. I could teach them my business philosophy and management techniques. It'd be a carbon copy of me. It would probably cost me a fortune, but if it works, then it's easy living. How would you feel about being adopted? Only joking. People would get funny ideas if I took in a child as old as you. Donate for the sake of the less fortunate, huh?
It'll be a full moon again in just another week, finally. This will be the 12th ordeal. Are you ready? I can't tell if time's been at a crawl or flying on by, but either way, a lot's happened, hasn't it? It's a bit soon to be reminiscing, though. How about I come see you once it's over? Be careful now.
Thank you.
Sorry, but I need your advice again. Let's meet up after art club like we did the other day. Don't tell anyone else about this, okay? I'm still torn on studying abroad. My dad's trying to make all my decisions for me. He chose the school I'd go to, the dorm I'd live in. He even bought my plane ticket already. And I haven't actually agreed to go through with it yet either. He's been like this ever since we argued about the art club. It's like he's suddenly trying to be more understanding. It's weird. It's not that I don't like it. It's just... it's the uncertainty of it all. Painting doesn't feel as fun anymore. Not to mention, I might never be a doctor. My teachers, my friends, and especially you. Everyone's been so supportive, and I know what you must be thinking. A chance to study abroad? What an opportunity. Sorry, it seems like all I ever do is complain to you, but I always feel a lot better after talking to you, so thanks. Now I don't even know what I really want to do. In times like this, I turn to the heavens. I have to head to the bookstore. You can go on without me. I'm buying a fortune-telling book and reading the whole thing in one night.
It's you. Sorry for surprising you. I had a feeling someone was in here, so I came to check. What's that? Did you find this? I see. He made a habit of not leaving behind any personal belongings, but... I have no idea when he filled out this form to return to school. Mother, he even planned to hand it in, but I think this is proof that he was thinking about the promise we made. Yes. He was so against it, and yet he still left this for us. I should show Akihiko, or actually, maybe I shouldn't. He probably wouldn't approve. Let's just keep this between us for now. It sounds like you know how to handle those two now.
Thanks to you, I was able to understand how he really felt. I'll say this on behalf of all three of us. Thank you so much. Here. You take this. It should go to you, since you're the one who got him to open up. Someday, once we leave the storm, then I'll tell Akihiko. I'll tell him about his struggle for turning to this room to fulfill the promise we made. But he never forgot those days when it was just the three of us. Not even for a moment.
Hellbiker.
Well, precisely.
To upgrade my outer appearance. First, I will triple the current surface area of my armor plating. After that, I will repaint my body gold and add a large dragon to my back. After reading this book, I came to a conclusion. This is what I have to do to appear strong and encourage people to depend on me. Outer appearances carry an influence that is beyond my ability to calculate. The main character of this story also carefully cultivated his image so everyone would take him seriously. That is why I'm looking into upgrading myself. In order for me to become more dependable, it's necessary I change my appearance. Don't you agree? Attitude? So that's what takes priority? Oh, could it be? I apologize. Please forget what I said about upgrading my appearance. It seems I had the completely wrong idea. At one point, the main character of the book says, "Can't have people think I ain't cool." Until then, he'd put so much effort into his attire, yet he goes to raid his rival's territory wearing nothing but a shimekomi. Thanks to you, I finally understand what's most important in life is having a strong heart to stay true to your beliefs. Therefore, I will also follow what I believe in. I may not appear dependable, but don't worry. I will adjust my attitude to reach maximum energy output and to increase my ammo stocks by 50%.
Oh, pretty simple.
For some reason, I feel like going to Tartarus and raising some hell.
Shall we conduct a raid? Oh, it's gotten so late. It doesn't seem like we'll be able to go tonight. How unfortunate. I'll just return to my room then.
Let's get on with today's lesson.
That lecture wasn't too bad.
So don't worry. Whew, what a relief. I'm glad he was able to contact the parents. What were they thinking, leaving that poor kid all alone? Stuff like that really makes me upset. But I guess my own mom's no different. Why do you want to know? Sorry. I didn't mean to poke fun at you. Remember what I told you before? Oh, my mom and I aren't very close? Well, if you ask me what kind of parent she is, I'd say a terrible one. She wasn't always like that, though. After what happened to Dad, she totally changed. She's probably living with one of her boyfriends somewhere. Honestly, I'd rather not know. Anyway, I'm done talking about this, okay? Could we keep this between you and me? You're the only one I've told. I'm not in the mood for karaoke anymore. Let's go home.
Welcome back.
This happened. How pathetic. Oh, I'm in bad shape. I just told you I'm in bad shape, didn't I? Don't piss me off, kid. Making my headache worse. I'm not gonna waste my breath repeating myself. I completely forgot I have a memorial service to conduct. Signing the Heart Sutra with a hangover is gonna be rough. Back in the day, all I needed was a cold shower and I'd be fine no matter how much I drank. I guess I'm getting old, huh? It's always in times like these. It's hardest to be alone. You act like you don't care about others, kid. You sure can be nosy when you want to. I got all these gaudy rings on now, but I used to wear a wedding ring, you know? If you think about it, it's better to be alone. Less stress. You don't have to wait for someone else to get out of the bathroom when you need to go. My son took forever in there. Yeah, living alone is the way to achieve peace and serenity. Everything we see has form. No form has permanence. All in constant motion. Form has no self. Its true face is that of emptiness. And yet, form is emptiness, and emptiness is form. No two things in this world are the same. Well, to put it simply, no matter how hard you try to live your life right, someone else can always mess it up. Because form is emptiness, and emptiness is form. Maybe getting involved with you messed up my life a bit, too. I'm gonna go home, kid. My head's killing me. Oh, yeah, about the memorial service. It was a seventh-day memorial. It was only 19. Random murder victim. What a harsh world we live in. Be careful on your way home too, kid.
morning. This is Elizabeth. I am calling one this time, I believe. Goodbye now.
Okay, let's begin. Then.
Oh, all current party members max HP? Interesting. All current party members max SP. Ooh. Even better.
All right.
Hey.
If I may speak. Excuse me.